There's two challenges that arise by virtue of Cordoma being rare. So first, on the research side, there's no single institution that sees a critical mass of patients to do all the research that needs to be done to understand the disease and develop better treatments. And on the patient side, patients are often scattered across the country and not necessarily next to centers that have a lot of experience treating Cordoma. They're not necessarily in a community where there are a lot of other Cordoma patients. And so the Cordoma Foundation serves as a connector on both sides for patients, to connect them with experienced physicians, to connect them with one another. And then on the research side, to create shared resources so that you can have a critical mass of specimens, models, et cetera, to be able to make the kind of progress that we ultimately seek to drive in this disease. When you're dealing with a rare disease, by necessity, you need to bring to bear the resources of multiple labs and multiple institutions. And so the only way to do that effectively is to create a set of shared resources, to create a commons built around biospecimens, built around models, built around data that lots of different labs can touch, can access, to, can contribute to. And so that's what we're trying to create for Cordoma, and that's why we're so excited to be working with CHOP and CBTTC. The traditional pace of research is not designed for patients. Academic research works on its own timeline, and patients have a very different timeline. So it's not uncommon for data to be generated over the span of 2 or 3 or 4 years, and then for it to sit in the lab during that time and to not ever see the light of day for the better part of 5 or 6 years. And that's just not acceptable when you're a patient dealing with an urgent challenge like Cordoma. So, part of our philosophy is to try to shorten that time span, to try to make data available as close to real time as possible, so that as data is coming out of one lab, other researchers can see it in real time and build upon it. So if we can condense that timeline from the time data is generated at the time the next lab can build upon it, then ultimately that compounds, and you can dramatically condense the timeline to reaching critical discoveries and ultimately better treatments.